What's up, man? It's your boy, Mr. Nick Bag TV, aka Blogaholic, man. And, right now, I want to just talk about, I know this is next year, but I want to say I'm personally endorsing Ron Paul for President of the United States for 2012. I really want people to start looking up this dude Ron Paul, because a lot of stuff he says makes perfect sense. It's like common sense. And I know a lot of black people are probably not going to feel that, because, you know, Ron Paul white, he's an old white guy. That's probably what they're going to use against him. Probably why he won't win. That's probably why people are going to tell you not to vote for him, because there's no chance he's going to win. But I really believe that more people should start giving Ron Paul a second look, or even a first look, man, because this dude makes a lot of sense. And one of the things he opened my eyes up to is this whole Obamacare thing. You know, I'm not going to lie and say I was never for it, because before, I looked on the scheme of things, you know, I listened to certain people and thought, like, ooh, Obama trying to get everybody healthy. That's what's up. He trying to, you know, better everybody's life. It's, you know, this, that. But then you got to think, got to use your brain and think, okay, free or not free, but a good deal on stuff. Even in the streets, a good deal is never a good deal. You know what I'm saying? Somebody coming to you with an HD TV for $50, that's a good deal. But you don't know who TV that was. That could be a drug dealer's TV they stole that's going to kill you if they see it. That could be anything, that's stolen property. It could be a tracking device in it that whoever bought this is going to go to jail because you buy stolen equipment. Could be just a setup, you know? But not to get too crazy with it, but the whole Obamacare thing, man, I was for it at first. But then I really looked into it, and I started looking up, you know, stuff. And I was hearing a lot of people, the Tea Party, they was talking about how the 10th Amendment, how Obamacare violates the 10th Amendment. The 10th Amendment is that, you know, basically in a nutshell, the federal government can't impose laws on the state government and mandate it. You know what I'm saying? So basically, the federal government can't control just by themselves. They can't just give, they just can't tell everybody what to do. You know, they have to go through proper channels and all this type of stuff. They can't just mandate something for everybody. They have done it, but as far as this Obamacare goes, they're saying that basically you have to get it. If you don't get it, you get fined. And if you don't get it, IRS is going to look up your stuff, make sure you got it, and they're going to go into all your paperwork. And that's right there, as a black man, it's something I can't really get with that, man. Like, I don't want the government in my business for nothing. Not nothing, man. And if you start giving up pieces of your rights, giving up pieces of whatever you got, especially when you black and you just give it to them, just say, here, you giving me that? Well, you know, when you just do that, you already trapped. They control you, man. And, you know, us as black people, we always, you know, think we unfair. We get treated unfair. We don't get enough. So when the government says they're giving us something, we so quick to take it without reading the fine print. Then we get stuck in the end looking like, hold on, how that happened? Then we want to march. Then we want to talk about this, that, and the third. And this right now is the time for people to really step back. You know, stop listening to so much, you know, craziness. And really look at the facts, man. Like, do you really want the government to get this one chance to see that they can sneak something in where they can basically impose on you to do a certain thing, and you think it's a good, you think it's free, or you think it's a gift, when realistically it's a gift to get more into your business to see what you're doing? And as a black person, I can't go with that, man. That's like the Patriot Act and all of that stuff, man. I can't do it anymore, man. I done got hemmed up on it, and I feel like I got hemmed up on it because it's my own fault, because I left my guard down, you know? I don't want to see nobody else leave your guard down. Don't listen to what everybody says. Don't even listen to what I say. Do your research, man. But that's why I'm going back to Ron. That's why I'm going to get back to Ron Paul and why I support him, because the dude makes perfect sense. He talked about, you know, America going to Libya. He broke that down. I was an idiot on that. I thought, you know, we going there for humanitarian reasons because Gaddafi is a dictator and he's messing with, you know. And then you listen to what Ron Paul said and you compare it to what Obama said. And it's like, yeah, you listen to what a lot of people are saying, though. It's like, okay, we going to Libya. one of the richest oil-rich country. We want to help them solve their problems, but we got problems in places like Sudan that has been going on in the world. But we don't care about their problems because we don't have nothing we need right now. But we get Gaddafi out, we put somebody else in, then he's listening to us, and then we good. And I don't know if this is true or not. They saying they paying Al Qaeda to beef with Gaddafi. Al Qaeda, the same Al Qaeda that supposedly took down our buildings. It's not adding up when you look at both sides. And that's what I want to put. If I have to vote, and I encourage people to vote, man, I will vote for Ron Paul. Like, real talk. Like, I will vote for Ron Paul just because I feel like he's our best chance to helping everybody. Now, I don't agree. Now, I'm not going to say I don't even agree. I'm not going to be like, I don't agree with the Tea Party, because I don't really know what the Tea Party really talks about. I don't know a lot of their philosophies or nothing. But with this whole Obamacare, they have valid points, man. And I'm willing to bite the bullet. Like, for real, I'm willing to bite the bullet, pay higher taxes. I don't care. I don't want the government in my business. Point blank, period, man. And all you people know, a lot of you guys know, that if you get into a car accident and break your leg and you go to the hospital, you're not going to pay that bill. You know that. So you got the Obamacare. You go there. You know you're not going to pay your bill. So they know you're not neither. So they basically say, okay, we know you're not going to pay. So instead of serving you the right way, we're going to half-ass it. And you're going to be good because it's a low-cost health care. So you'll get less. You're going to get less of a service for supposedly a deal. You know what I'm saying? It makes no sense. But that's where I'm at right now. I mean, that's who I'm endorsing. Ron Paul. Check out the website. And start listening to a lot of the stuff he says when he's on TV. Because every time I didn't see this dude, he's been making perfect sense about the health care, about the wars, about the Federal Reserve. All of this stuff is just on point, man. And I didn't fact check the dude and everything. And everything he has said has been truth. And a lot of stuff Obama has said has been lies. Like, Obama has lied to the black people, to people as a whole, just straight up to our face. I don't even want to say this, but I really fear for Obama, man, because I don't know if he's doing stuff he don't even know he's doing. He's a smarter guy than I am, but like Farrakhan said, after Obama is out of office, what is it left for him to do? Like, what is he going to do after he's out of office? All the peace, goodwill, and all the stuff he said when he was running that he rode on and campaigned on, all that goodwill is gone since he's been president. He's been probably more of a warmonger than Bush was, especially in his first 2 years. This dude didn't kill Bin Laden. He didn't kill dude. He didn't get no just cause. We didn't bring him in and read him his rights. We went to go kill him. And now we're gonna try to prosecute Gaddafi over war crimes when we just committed one? We just went to somebody else's country without asking them to kill somebody? It's right in our face, people. Just start reading more. Peace out.